Hi, my name is Jonas. Estuera is back. After more than 10 years, a string of new Estuera releases is being planned on Black Hole, and the first one, Umbra, is going to be released very soon, or probably when you're watching this video has already been released. Today I'm going to give you a quick walkthrough on how I produced this track. Let's take a look. Umbra is Latin for shadow or darkness. The idea started with the CS80V. It's Arturia's virtual version of the classic Yamaha CS80, the greatest synth ever. I really love it. I was playing around with it and I came up with this melody. Then I used Steinberg's Patch Up 2 to add these nice pads, and it already gives this nice dark moody atmosphere. So what I needed next was some good bottom end. For this purpose I used the MS-20, well, the virtual version unfortunately again. MS-20 is a great synth for dirty basses and all kinds of dirty leads. It's really perfect almost, and I use it quite a lot in this track. I use it for two kinds of basses and actually for the saw lead as well. You will see that later. For the bass, the first part is this also a kind of detuned saw kind of thing, which I gated so it opens on the offbeat and it goes like this. So in the break, first it's really deep, and then I'm going to slowly open up the filter. And I layered it with another MS-20, that is, if I solo it, a similar sound, but a little bit less dirty, but a little bit more low end. Combined, they fill out the bottom really nice. Adding some percussion. So for the kick, I used the Punch 2. Actually, it's just two samples layered on top of each other. One is a little bit lower, the other one is a little bit more mid-low. Combined, they give this nice punch that really punches through the track. Then I added a closed hi-hat, which has this reverb and a little bit of a phasing effect on it. Gives a nice ambience. Sounds like this. And then it's mostly a bunch of loops, actually. Sometimes I program the percussion completely myself, but in this case I was just going fast and adding a couple of loops and it sounded really good. So I have this conga loop, this other top loop, yet another top loop, and then as a cherry on the cake, this bit of a dirty techno loop. Gives a lot of character. Combined with the bass, it's a very nice and solid groove where I can put all the melodic elements on top of, and then you get this nice contrast of a bit of a dirty progressive groove, really dark and moody, and some lighter melancholic melodic elements on top of it. Actually, that's the classic recipe for an Estuera track. Then another melodic element is this Omnisphere plucky arp sound. And the final melodic element is once again the MS-20. It's a detuned saw and it's playing a simple arpeggio following the chords. And this is a really very trancy, typical trancy sound. I almost didn't use it because I thought it was maybe a little bit too cliche, but then when I tried it out in the track and the kick dropped in, It sounded just really nice and energetic, and I thought, why not? It's 2020. We can do anything we want. So I just kept it in, and I think it works really great. It's a few interesting contrasts, actually. So you have this housey, progressive, dark groove. You have the melancholic, classic Estuera synthesizer and pad melodic elements. And then, which is quite new for Estuera, actually, you have this quite classic trance detuned saw arpeggio. Let's listen to that one. So yeah, it opens up. And then throwing in kick in the bass. One final accent is this retrologue. It's noise that is following the same pattern, just to give a little bit more accents to the high end. And then the only things that we still need are some effects to guide the transitions. One of the cool ones here is this kind of a gong sweep effect. Especially the reversing part of this effect is very interesting, and it gives the transitions a very nice unique character. And the other effect is more of a launching thing, so it's a rising effect. I created it with a demo of the Steinberg Backbone. I had it months ago. I was trying it out, and I think I loaded in some percussion sound. I don't really remember what it was, and it got stretched a lot, and I pitch shifted it, and actually it turned into this big rising, sweeping, launching sound. And I thought it sounded cool. I rendered it to audio, and it actually ended up in this track. So let's listen to that one. And actually, those are all the elements I needed. Don't forget, less is more. That's what I always say. You don't need to have loads of layers and effects and everything to make an interesting track. I think if you have a good basic idea, you should add as little as possible to make it work. And I hope I succeeded in this, although it never is perfect, of course. Let's listen to the track for a little bit. But before we do that, check out the video description. There you will find links to where to stream this, where to download this, and other information about Umbra. This is just the first of already three Estueras that are going to be released on Magic Music, the sublabel of Black Hole. This is the dark, groovy one. The second one is going to have a little bit more of a melodic, hopeful vibe, but I'm not going to spoil too much about that one yet. That one will be for January. Let's listen to this track now, and I'll see you next time. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel if you want more like this. Bye bye.